Hello everyone, and Merry Christmas, and this is our last class of 2015. We're going to summarize a couple of things we did on the last class of West Coast One. All right, so real quick, we reviewed the opener. I did another version that was my preference, which was the rotating one, which was triple step, rock, step, and tuck, turn, triple step. This one was a simpler version. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a tap step. So my perspective lanes is opposite. We're going to do tap, step. Then I'm going to do rock step. Wherever her heel goes, that's going to determine where the surfboard is. So if I did straight back, she would do a surfboard this way. But if I want the surfboard to go this way, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It's essentially a tuck turn. But instead of walking forward 2 steps, she's doing a rock step on that one. All right? So from this perspective, I'm going tap, step, rock, step, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. Guys, if you want to do the even more minimalist version, we can just go groove. You're counted by 6. Here we go. Rock, step, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. All right? So the other thing we did is, and you can just do another arm turn from that to get out of that. All right, we did our sugar tuck into hammerlock. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You'll notice I move a little bit forward and I move to my left off of the surfboard. Because if I don't, I usually end up like this, which isn't too flattering, plus gives her a feeling that she's supposed to point that way, instead of down to the end of the surfboard. So you can do it on 3, 5, 7, any odd count. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, and 6. Bring the hand in front of you. Those are just the fingers, and ladies are looking down to the other end of the surfboard. And once you're in hammerlock, ladies, look a little bit at him that puts your body in the correct position. Then what we did is a circle. 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm pulling with my right hand slightly. And now that I have her facing the direction I want, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then you can just do a sugar push or a side pass, whatever we want. Okay? The other version, we did a tuck turn version. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, and 8. Again, I move towards her on that roll of the hemlock. Hand in front of me, she's facing me. Then pull with my right hand. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Let's walk in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I can just send her to the other end right here without circling, or I can circle faster. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. In which case, it's a 1.5 turn instead of a single turn. Right? So just another alternative. The last thing we did was the whip. Just kind of review what a regular whip is. We're going to bring her towards us. When she steps on her right foot, I'm going to circle her body. So my action here is 1, 2. Get them getting out of the way. I'm going to catch her in this case. I'm going to go 1, 2. With my left hand, circles her body after she steps on that foot. She's going to go through the end. And I'm going to step cross on 4. Not crowding her too much. And then take my right shoulder back, and I'm looking back with my head over that shoulder so I can see if there's anything in the way. It also gets my shoulder out of the way, and it helps me to get her rotational momentum. 6, 7, and 8. Again, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. On the other side, I need 2 more positions. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Make sure you let her go away from you on 3 and. And bring him a little bit towards you on 4. Then he's staying his hand on 4. 5, 6, 7, and 8. All right? And then this perspective, facing the camera. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. That's it. Thank you very much.